Hey guys, Noah here and welcome back to my channel. So one of the ways that I've actually been able to grow my business is by diversifying my revenue and having multiple streams of income. I think it's really important that if you want to grow your business, you have different sources so you're not just too reliant on any one way of making money. So that's what I'm going to be talking about in today's video. I'm going to be sort of breaking down my business and I'm going to be showing you all the ways of all the sites I sell on and the different aspects of my business. So let's jump into my computer. So before we get into it, I just want to say that this video is going to be a bit longer. I feel that I can get more information as well as give you guys more value in a longer format video, but let me know in the comments if you want longer videos or shorter videos. So the way that my business works is I will always find a supplier. So S is going to stand for supplier. And when I'm looking for suppliers, I typically will most likely look for suppliers that can dropship since that's what I mainly do in my business. So I will always look for a supplier that I can source from through dropshipping. Now, when you find a supplier that you can dropship from, you can also buy them wholesale. So you can buy all the items that you buy in dropshipping or that you source through dropshipping, you can actually get those in wholesale. So these are the two ways that I actually source from my supplier. So D stands for dropshipping, W stands for wholesale. And the way or the reason that this actually works is because when you're dropshipping, you don't have any inventory. So essentially, you don't know what items are going to sell well because you don't need to. You can just list items, and if it doesn't sell, then it doesn't cost you anything because you're not actually buying anything up front. But let's say that item sells well, you can then go ahead, and that's what I've been doing recently in my business, is I've been buying more inventory. I've been buying more in bulk. This way, I could send it into Amazon FBA, and I can have stock right here at my house or in my warehouse, and I could send items out, and it actually improves my metrics. So these are the two different aspects for my business. Now it's really important that you understand that these don't really contradict each other. It's not like I'm drop shipping and then I also am doing private label on Amazon. These both work because I'm sourcing from the same supplier. It's just two different ways of sourcing products and actually going about your business. The next way that I actually build my business or the next way I diversify my income is from the different sales channels that I actually sell on. So I will always drop ship and I'll do wholesale, but I'll sell on multiple different sites. So I sell on eBay, I sell on Amazon, I sell on Etsy, I sell on all of these different sites like Bonanza and Shopify. So I'm just gonna put sites here. So these are gonna be like 10 to 12 different sites that I sell on and that I list products on. Now the reason that I think it's really important that I do this, and this is what's actually allowed my business to grow, is because it actually allows me to reach more customers as well as allows me to target a certain type of customer. So now let me get into why I do this. So the first reason is the two methods for sourcing. Number one is that you have wholesale, you can buy in bulk. This allows me to actually do Amazon FBA, get shorter shipping times and all of that jazz. So this is also very versatile because you work with suppliers who could do both. Now back to what I was saying, when you're sourcing and you're actually selling on multiple different sales channels, this is a way to manage risk for your business as well as allows you to also grow. So the way that you're actually managing risk is because let's say this month my eBay sales are not doing as well. I think I only did around, I think I'm down like 30% in my overall sales, but that's because my eBay sales are down and the items I sell don't really do as well at this time of year. So because my eBay sales aren't doing well, if I was just selling on eBay, then my overall business would not be doing well. But since that's only a smaller portion of my sales, and I do also sell on Amazon and Etsy, and I also have my own Shopify website, and I have Bonanza, it doesn't hurt my business or my monthly revenue as much. So that's what I'm saying. It's kind of risk management, and it kind of is all packed into one monthly revenue, and you're not just hurt if one of your channels doesn't do well. So the next thing that it actually allows me to do is it actually allows me to reach more customers. There are stories that I hear of customers who only shop on Amazon, and they'll never look at eBay, and vice versa. You have customers who only shop on eBay and they'll never shop on Amazon. So this way, since I'm in both places, it actually allows me to reach more customers. Now, this is just mainly for eBay and Amazon. I don't know anyone who is going to go ahead and shop on Bonanza, but I'll get to in a second why I think it's really important that you actually list there as well. So the next site that I want to talk about is Etsy. Now, Etsy is a way that I can actually target certain customers without paying for any ads or without doing any of that stuff like Google ads or anything like that. So the customers that actually come to Etsy are looking for home decor. They're looking for handmade items, vintage items, all of that sort of unique type of items. So this site right here is highly customizable towards those types of customers, because when they come to this site, they're going to be looking for a certain type of item. And if they were to see the same item on eBay or on Amazon, chances are they might not buy it. But if they come here and they actually look for that item, then they are more likely to buy those home decor, the home goods, the vintage items. So if you have any of those types of items, I highly recommend listing them on Etsy, because most likely those items will actually do well. So selling on niche sites is a very good way to target a certain customer and increase your sales potentially for a certain type of product that might not do well on eBay or on Amazon or any of the bigger, more broad marketplaces. Now, the next thing that I want to talk about is Bonanza and TrueGether and all of these sites that actually allow you to advertise for free, and you can actually upload your items to these sites for free. So what I mean by that is Bonanza. Bonanza is a site that most people don't know of. I don't really know if a lot of people shop on here. I tend to get a lot of sales from this site, and the reason for that is because they will advertise your products for free. Not only that, but they also integrate with eBay that you can upload all of your items on eBay straight onto Bonanza without having to list every single item over again. So it saves you a lot of time, and it actually allows you to potentially get more sales and get your items in front of more customers, not just on a site that people don't visit, but they will actually advertise your site on Google, they'll advertise your site on Bing, or all of your items on Google and Bing. And this is a great way to utilize a site that is advertising for free in order to get customers acquisition and using Google Shopping, because where do most customers go when they are actually going to search for an item that they want to purchase? Most people are going to go to Google. I don't think anyone goes to Bing or Yahoo, but Bonanza does advertise there as well. Now, TrueGether is another site that I just started selling on. I have not seen anyone talk about it on YouTube. I've gotten around 20 sales, and I've only been selling on here for around 4 months. This site advertises on Google completely for free, as well as they don't really have any seller fees. So you also get really good margins on the site, and it's not too expensive. I don't really know how they make money, but it's another site that someone referred me to, and I've been selling on here, and it's been going very well. But these types of sites are the eBay knockoff sites, and since they're trying to actually gain market share, you can utilize free advertisements, and it doesn't cost you a single penny, nor does it take a lot of time. It might take 15 minutes to initiate the import, and once you actually import your items, this is a great way to get more sales and get your items in front of more customers. So just to show you an example, on Bonanza, you can actually import from eBay, you can import from Amazon, you can import from Etsy, you can import from Shopify, or you can do a CSV import. So it's super easy to go ahead and upload all of your items. It doesn't take you that much time, and it's completely free except for when your item sells. Now, I know that you might be thinking that it's really not worth it for you to list your items on these sites, because if you think about it, you've probably never heard of Bonanza, you've probably never heard of TrueGether, and it's probably just a waste of time. But that's what I thought, and then I started listing my items on these sites. Like I said, it's completely free, and even though this is not a huge majority of my sales, I am getting additional sales, additional revenue, which leads to more profit, which is ultimately better for any business. So like I said, this is not a lot, but it's an extra $2,000 or it's an extra $3,000 in some cases every single month in sales. So for July, for this month, for last month, I did $3,200 on Bonanza, which is something that I would not have gotten if I did not list my items, and it doesn't take any time away. So this is how I've diversified my business. This is how I get more sales and get my items in front of more customers, as well as also utilizing wholesale from my suppliers, because I can buy an item in bulk that is selling well. So that is what I want to stress in my videos, that you should always be trying to take your next step in your business. Now, just to show my Etsy sales, so this is for the month of August, and for all time, I've been selling on Etsy for around 4 or 5 months. So as you can see, it started in May, that's when the sales started to pick up. So I did $422, then I did $2,700, $2,600, and these are all sales that I would not have gotten if I hadn't listed on Etsy. Now, granted, Etsy doesn't import from eBay, but you wouldn't want to sell all of the items that you sell on eBay onto Etsy, just a select few. But these are ways that you can grow your sales, diversify your revenue streams, and get more views for your products, and like I said, get more sales. So I hope that you guys found this video helpful. I hope that you also enjoyed this video. This was just to show you how I actually structure my business, because I don't just sell on any one different platform. I was selling on eBay for around 3 years and I was doing okay. But as soon as I started selling on Amazon, I nearly doubled my sales, because Amazon now does twice the amount of revenue that I do on eBay. And I wouldn't have done that if I didn't start listing on Amazon. And then I started listing on Etsy, as well as I started listing on Bonanza. So these are just ways that you can get more sales, get more customers, and hopefully grow your business. So thank you for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to leave a comment telling me what type of the videos you guys would like to see, as well as you can also check out the Facebook group that is linked down below. I am going to start being more active in there, and I'll see you guys in the next video.